greatly to be praised. Great is the Lord. Hallelujah. Father, we worship you. Woohoo! There's none like you, Father, in all the heavens. There's none like you in all the earth, oh God. We lift our voice and praise your holy name, Lord Jesus. We lift our voice and praise your name, Almighty God. Blessed is your name, Lord. Hallelujah. Cobra making on the Mondera Cide, Mandela Mandero. I will rejoice and be glad. I will rejoice and be glad. You're my glory and the lifter of my head, oh God. You're my glory and the lifter of my head, oh Lord. I will rejoice and be glad in you. I will rejoice and be glad in you. You are my joy and the rejoicing of my heart, oh God. Find a harmony. You are my joy and the rejoicing of my heart, oh God. I will be glad, for you have made me glad. I will be glad, for you have made me glad. I will be glad, for you have made me glad. You are my joy, hallelujah, woo! And the rejoicing of my heart. Lord, you are my joy and the rejoicing of my heart. Oh Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. You are my glory and the lifter of my head. Oh Lord, you are my glory and the lifter of my head. Oh Lord, you are my glory and the lifter of my head. Oh Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. I will be glad, for you have made me glad. Lord, you're my shield about me. You're the lifter of my head. Oh, you're a shield about me. The lifter of my head, Lord, you're a shield about me. You, the lifter of my head, you, my shield about me. You're the lifter of my head. I will be glad, for you have made me glad, Lord. I will be Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. You're my glory and the lifter of my head. Oh Lord, you're my glory and the lifter of my head. Oh Lord, you are my glory and the lifter of my head. Oh Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. I will be glad, for you have made me glad. Oh Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. My Lord, I will be glad, for you have made me glad. Lord Jesus, we praise you.
Hallelujah.
It's G minor.
Lord Jesus, we praise you. Lord Jesus, we praise you. Holy is your name, Lord, we praise you. Holy is your name, Lord, we worship you. Holy is your name, O God, we praise you. Holy is your name, Lord, we praise you. Oh Lord, you are so good, so merciful and gracious. Your ways past finding out.
Hallelujah. 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 Praise the Lord. Lord, we worship you. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you. Thank you, mighty God, for your love and kindness. Thank you, Lord God, for your tender mercies. Hallelujah. Lord, we worship you.
Do the relative major.
Lord, we worship you.
G. It's in B.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Lord, we praise you, mighty God. Lord, we praise you, Lord. We worship you, Lord. Lord, we praise you. Lord, we praise you.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Lord Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Hallelujah. Lord Jesus. What a glorious, wondrous, wondrous, glorious, glorious, wondrous Savior you are. What a glorious, wondrous, wondrous, glorious, glorious, wondrous Savior you are. Mama na ne me na ma nevra na na la na he. Bevra mama ne ishi pere na na ma na ne ni ke he. Hallelujah. What a wondrous, glorious, glorious, wondrous Savior you are, Lord Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. What a glorious, wondrous, wondrous, glorious Savior you are, Lord. Hallelujah. What a glorious, wondrous, glorious, wondrous, glorious, glorious, wondrous Savior you are, Lord Jesus. Here my mama and there in the pier to fall in a here my no lolo borum and he shot an eye here my man do va man on de ra man de ro mo man de ra ma man de le pi zero man van da la nem ben men gala na man be 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 la na man da bra fatilo hallelujah zero man ve bra man van de la men du ru man de ru van van de Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Hira mamando se te breve parva tabra de veina. Hallelujah. Shikara mamba bondora me bembe in candolo bolsa patira ta. Hallelujah. 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 Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Ikara mamam bamba mamande bre bem 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 mendula mamanda le mena la mana na singalingala no monga dem bre mamande de bio shapora ni bio la taya de. Shikara mamala vasi ala na nero nai zira na nero. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Mamande. Hallelujah! Oh, blessed is your name, Lord. Ha 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 Se bevre be banda la da bamba ma bebe be cuda la mambre de de resira la na manda de che shito do barro patara de vre de che taia taia do no monda. Berre me mamma ben bene. Berre me mamma mandando lo sande de gen de la mandirina. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, mama de bre mama no de veni alla nombra va sede di ali tu. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, mighty God. Well, you can be seated. Sikara mama manjibre mambondolo bosateru mamba gete yandola. If you want to be, you can stand, you can continue to stand if you would like. Sikara mamba mambabre, whatever you do, whatever position or posture you take, don't stop worshiping. Worshiping. If you have to stand to worship, continue to stand by all means. Hallelujah. Thank you, Father, for your great love wherewith you loved us. Oh God, we thank you for your love wherewith you loved us. We thank you, Lord, for this love wherewith you love us. We thank you, Lord, for this love wherewith you love us. Oh God, this love that you poured in our hearts. 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 We thank you, Lord, for this love wherewith you loved us. Lord, we thank you for this love wherewith you loved us. This love that you put in our hearts. This love that you put in our hearts. This love that you poured in our hearts. Hallelujah. Well, we want all of you to just begin to experience the joy of the Lord right now, because His joy is here. There's several realms to plug in right now. We pray you take the better realm. Father, our heart cries out for you, oh God. For the living God. Just like the deer that pants for the water brook, oh God, our soul, it pants for you, oh Lord. Our hearts cry out to you, oh Lord. Let your glory overwhelm our hearts and lives. Let your will be done, oh God, we pray in Jesus' name. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in your lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That you may receive all glory. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That you may receive all praise. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That you may receive all glory. That you may receive all honor. That you may receive all praise. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives, oh God. That your will be done in our lives. That you may receive all glory. That you may receive all honor. That you may receive all praise. Let your will be done in our lives, oh God. Let your will be done in our lives, oh God.
that your will be done in our lives, O God, that you may receive all glory, that you may receive all honor, that you may receive all praise. Hallelujah. Father, we ask you right now in the mighty name of Jesus, let your fire fall. Father, we pray in Jesus' mighty name that every person in this place will begin to be filled with the Spirit. Oh God, I pray, Father, right now in the mighty name of the living God, the name that is above every name, that every soul will be apprehended by you, oh God, that every person in this place would turn their lives completely over to you and allow you to rule and reign in every dimension, in everything, oh God. They would call you Lord Jesus, Master. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Jesus, Jesus, Christ Jesus. Hallelujah. He got almost up, but I'm a man daily man, but I'm a man brave, ve cuta la basete. Do that with me. Si breve venangla mondira, na 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 ne la mane hale boromonze, sere mala mangere mamandoro sotto reme male le mingela, zere mamandoro babebe briba la batusto rema mindolo, chiebra mamande bribati blefri mombo, sitolo mombevri vegila, promundo primindira, sotto ria valai, alleluia. Kebra ve pro mangera va be pro mamandobli be te pro mamangela va le comandori zebra va pri bolo mangebra ve be pri mamanelo zebra be gisto lo mambebra va du lo ma zebra va burro mamendebra ve guro vise zorra va burra mamangera ve dilo Zebra babitolo mbalene, zebra babitolo mangila, zebra babori mamanina, zebra badulo mamanuna, zebra begi kolo mondere, zebra bialop maleyalopan, zebra begi le mandur manene sheno, zebra babri bovro mandere balituya. Hallelujah. Zebra babino mane imoye lingaya. Zero babi bro mambori mandeleo, zero vegi na nonori mamande brevidie robobori be, zoba baturo mambori nambero, zebra vegi tolo mori vele bro mamandul mende brevo. Alleluia. That's right, go ahead. This is how you connect with God the Holy Ghost. This is how you do it right here. Hallelujah. Right here in this realm of praise, where you press in beyond all things that would stop you or hinder you or distract you or keep you back, whether it's sickness or pain, sorrow or grief, no matter what it is, circumstance or situation, there's a realm of glory that you can choose. There's a place of refreshing. There's a place of blessing. There's a place of grace where God will fill you to the full. Come drink. He'll fill you to the full. Come drink. He'll fill you to the full, to overflowing like rivers with the praises of the Lord. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Fill me, O God. Hallelujah. I want to be full. Hallelujah. Fill me, O Lord. I want to be full. Oh, fill me, O Lord. I want to be full. Full of you. Full of you. Full of God. Hallelujah. Fill me, O Lord. I want to be filled. I'll drink right now so the river can flow. I want to be filled to the full, filled to the full with you, Lord. I want to be filled to the full, filled to the full with you, Lord. I want to be filled to the full, filled to the full with you. I want to be filled to the full, filled to the full with you, Lord. I want to be filled to the full, drunk on new wine with your glory. Fill me now, fill me now with you. Hallelujah. 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 Lord, you're my Lord. Oh, you're my Lord. You have risen from the dead, and you're my Lord. Oh, and my knees I bow, and with my tongue confess, Lord Jesus, you're my Lord. Lord, you're my Lord. Oh, you're my Lord. Lord, you my Lord, oh, you my Lord, oh, you have risen from the dead, and you're my Lord, oh, and my knees I bow, and with my tongue I confess that Jesus Christ is my Lord. Lord Jesus, you're my Lord, you're my Lord, you're my Master and my Lord. Oh, you're my Lord, you're my Lord, you're my Master and my Lord. Lord, you're my Lord, you're my Lord, you're my Master and my Lord. Jesus Christ, my Master and my Lord. Oh, you have risen from the dead, and you're my Lord. Oh, you are seated on the throne, and you're my Lord. You're exalted to the right hand of the Father, King of kings, and you're my Lord, Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, you're my Lord. Oh, you're my Lord, Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, you're my Lord. Oh, you're my Lord, Lord Jesus Christ. Oh, you're my Lord. Oh, you have risen from the dead, and you're my Lord. You've been seated in the throne, and you're my Lord. Oh, you're exalted by the right hand of the Father, Jesus Christ. Oh, you're my Lord, Lord Jesus Christ. You're my Lord. Hallelujah. 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 Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah, oh, hallelujah, 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 hallelujah.
That's pretty much how I enter into the presence of the Lord.
Ha 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 ha. Oh, hallelujah, hallelujah,
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Oh, hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm my beloved's and he is mine. Oh, 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 I'm my beloved's and he is mine. Now, when you have this, you don't need a CD player. You don't have to have the worship team from the church follow you around so you can be in the anointing. Hallelujah. So that you can touch heaven. It's a choice of your will. You don't open your mouth and begin to proclaim the good things of God, you're not going to have anything. You're only going to have what you can supply. Well, that won't last long because there's one stronger than you that's going to overtake and fill the void when God's not allowed to fill you. And it's pretty ruthless. And so I just encourage everybody, don't do that anymore. That ain't going to work out real well. Rather, just be continually filled with the Spirit. Just simply obey the Lord. And He's just so good. He's, hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise God. Right now, you have the privilege and the opportunity right where you're sitting. You do not have to move. You do not have to change another chair. You don't have to do anything, and you could be, just simply by yielding, filled with the love of God which passes knowledge, the love of Christ Jesus, to know the love of Christ Jesus right where you're seated right now, and then be filled with all the fullness of God. And I guarantee you'll look a whole lot different than you look right now. Hallelujah. So go ahead and practice. Might as well practice. Can't get good at anything unless you practice. Amen. Hallelujah. So I'm just going to practice right now. My wife's over here practicing. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. That's it. I see some things happening now. There we go. That's it. Hallelujah. Mama kashala mangibra kataki no kokuri katara. Manda este rebete ishara boborata. I want everybody to open up your Bibles to Luke chapter 8 and verse 24. Master, carest thou not that we perish? You there? Luke chapter 8, verse 24. Master, don't you even care? Don't you even care? Yeah, don't you see what's going on? Hello? Lord, carest thou not? Are you there? Have you opened your Bibles? Are you there? I wonder how many times people in this place thought that today. In one way or the other. Huh? One way or the other. Or over the past week. I assure you, I haven't. I have not. Because I found a realm of praise. I found a realm of thanksgiving. I found a realm of faith that I want to talk to you about tonight. I want you to get out of carest thou not that we perish. Now, we're talking about the 12 apostles.
with Jesus Christ, hallelujah, separated unto himself, appointed to represent him. When I, many times studying the reactions, actions of the apostles, I received great encouragement and comfort in just looking at the ministry of Jesus and its effect on 12 people. And hey, well, you know what? The reality of it is the Lord set us up so that we could be comforted in all of our tribulation. He set it up so that you and I could receive great confidence and boldness no matter what we're going through. Because I'm going to tell you, doubt, unbelief, sorrow, anxiety, frustration, discouragement, whatever you want to call it, it ain't going to get the job done. Say, complaining to God and saying, hey, wake up, Lord. Don't you realize where we at? Don't you even care what's going on in my life? Come on. I mean, we're stuck down here about to die, okay? We in the midst of a storm. We in the midst of a battle. When are you going to throw in? I mean, come on. Ha, ha, ha. Hey, hello. How are you tonight? Well, Jesus immediately let them know exactly how much he cared. Now, you're going to have to listen. Otherwise, what's going to happen is you're going to go right back into the same problems, and you're going to find yourself in the same struggles, and you're going to get so overwhelmed, and you're going to get so disappointed, and you're going to get so discouraged that you're going to give up and become faint of heart and just feel like you can't go on. And that's a state that you don't want to be in, because there's no growth there. There's no maturity there. There's no blessings there. There's no goodness there. There's no advancing the kingdom of God. There's no exploits there. There's no real relationship that knows God that produces the fruit that he demands. So, hello. Good evening. We want to encourage you tonight. We want you to see how quickly Jesus responded. You know, he immediately rose up, rebuked the wind, great calm came. And then they're like, and he says, where's your faith? And I believe that over and again, the Lord encourages us. He comes and he shows. If everybody would just step back and begin to rehearse the things, the events of their life, they would see the hand of God in their life. They would see where the Lord came and did great things to encourage you and to build you up, and so that you're able to be equipped and certain and confident about when you go through trying situations, when you go through troubling times, to recognize that there's an authority that's been given to you. It's in your heart and in your mouth to speak out. I mean, he's not just going to arise and do something. He's living and walking in the midst of us, but we have to agree with him. There's got to be a point in our life where you and I allow the Word of God to become that supreme and absolute governorship over our life, not our own thoughts, not our own calculations, our own thinking, or, you know, our own imaginations, but rather just let the Word of God have control over our life, have rule over our life. Let patience have her perfect work in your life. Understand that really God's purpose right now is to make you every bit entire or fully furnished or complete and perfect unto every good work, so that you're lacking nothing. I'm asking you tonight, are you lacking something in your life? What is it that you're lacking? People might go through the list, you know. I'm just to encourage you tonight. Do you have an explosive anointing going on in your life? Did you come with one? Do you have one now? You're going to leave with one. Do you have a fellowship and a relationship that God died for you to have and rose again the third day for you to be able to every day enjoy, is exalted by the right hand of the Father, given a name above every name, so that you can walk in increasing it more and more every day. It's not up to God. It's up to you. It's what's up to him, he's already done. He doesn't withhold from anybody. He doesn't withhold from anybody. He likes you. You're not an exception. He loves you. And there's not a single person that he's left out of this. Now, hallelujah. Amen. Hallelujah. Barokanene. Now the one we call the parakaleo is, which, you know, the parakaleo or the parakaletos, which is more commonly referred to as parakaletos, but as parakaletos, that he is the comforter. He is the helper. Parakaleo means to come and encourage you and to come and comfort you and to come and embolden you and to come and give you an absolute sense of encouragement and, my goodness, and blessing that you know that you can rise up and do anything. See, Paul said this. Let's just look at this for just 1 second and then look in 2 Corinthians chapter, what is it? 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse, 2 Corinthians chapter 1 verse 4. Look at this. God, blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, the Father of mercies and the God of all comfort. He's the God of all parakaleo. And that parakaleo came from the parakaletos. And the parakaletos is what Jesus said, I'm going to send you the parakaletos. I'm going to send you the Holy Ghost. We translated it three times in the Bible in John chapter 14, John chapter 15, John chapter 16. We translated that comforter. But it's a comfort that causes you to be able to, in all the midst of a tribulation and trial and situation that you go through, count it all joy. Well, how can you count it all joy if you're not comforted? How can you count it all joy if you're not certain? How can you count it all joy if you're not emboldened, if you're not encouraged? How can you ever begin to move in a realm of faith if you think that you're on your own, somehow you isolated, somehow God doesn't like you, somehow he loves everybody but me, me, me. I mean, you know, don't sing that song no more. Jesus loves everyone but me. Because that just obviously isn't true. Don't sing it on any level. Understand the great boldness that is in knowing and believing the love that God has for you. Understand the great boldness and comfort there is. You know, people, we cry out to the Lord and we say, Lord, send your fire. Then the fire comes and you're going, what's going on now? It's a trying of your faith. It's a trying of your patience. It's a trying of everything that's going on in your life. And don't say send you fire unless you want fire. Say don't send you fire if you don't want fire. If you don't want to be prepared unto every good work, don't tell God to use you. Because he's going to answer your prayer. He's going to take it for granted that you really mean what you're saying, that you want to increase in the anointing and in his manifest presence. And then you tell God, oh God, do whatever it takes. Do whatever you need to do. Shine your floodlight of heaven upon my soul. Oh God, reveal everything. Make known everything that needs to be revealed, made known. Then it starts happening. Then you start complaining and saying, Master, carest thou not? No, he cares very well. He's right in the midst of it. Mm-hmm. And if you can understand it, then you can count it all joy when you fall into many different temptations. Some of you are in heaviness right now. Some of you have been in heaviness for a long time. As Peter refers to in 1 Peter chapter 1, he said, you're in heaviness right now because you're in trouble. That's what he said. You're in trouble by the trying of your faith. You found yourself right in the midst of the will of God, being prepared, being taught, being led, being instructed. Now you're in a storm, think you're going to die. You're not. He's not going to let you die. I promise you. I promise you. How many times have you gone through, I'm going to die, and you came through it? Hallelujah. How many times? How many times? I'm going to die. The Lord wants to, hallelujah. Father wants to give you a great encouragement. He wants to fill you with courage. He wants to fill you with boldness. He wants to fill you with strength. He wants to fill you with confidence. He wants to make you so brave. Amen. He wants you to make you so certain. Look, listen, dear people, I want you to understand If you don't make the things of the Lord the most important thing to you, if you don't make the things of God the most important thing in your life, you're going to be terribly miserable and frustrated as a Christian.
That's true.
If you will make everything that belongs to the Lord the most important thing in your life, and that's going to cost you. You're going to have to say goodbye to all of the stuff that has attached and affixed itself to your heart that belongs to the pleasure of this world, the cares of this life, the deceitfulness of riches, all those things that pull on you that actually are what causes your disappointment. If you want to understand how to be successful in dealing with the forces of hell that are against you, you're going to have to realize that that God has called us and instructed us to overcome by the word of our testimony. That's the word of the living God. That's the word, the gospel that we preached by the blood of Jesus Christ. And because we're all willing to be martyrs, because we count ourselves completely having given over to the Lord Jesus Christ, no longer alive, willing to do what he wants us to do, go wherever he wants us to go, be whatever he wants us to be. If he wants to lead me to a cross to be crucified, if it's ultimately I'm going to end up being thrown in the midst of lions and being torn apart, if I'm going to be whatever it is, whatever. So many people suffered great things in the past, suffer great things now. But he's the God of all comfort. God, the Holy Ghost, has come to comfort you. He's come to make you brave. He's come to give you an absolute boldness and confidence and certainty so that you can stand there and celebrate in the midst of the will of the Father. Hallelujah. Having a good time. Hallelujah. But you can't do this if you attach to the world. You can't do this if you still are fixed to the world. The world's going to have to be crucified to you, and you're going to have to be willing to be crucified to the world. You're going to have to quit finding pleasures and comfort in this world, because Satan will get a claw and a hook in you and jerk you wherever he wants to jerk your emotions. He'll jerk your passions wherever he wants to jerk them. He will have you, he'll have his way with you when he wants. He'll let you do a little praising every once in a while if that's going to make you happy. But at the end of the day, he's going to jerk you right into his iniquity and his way, because he's your master. He's not my master. My master. I have the word of the testimony of the Lord Jesus Christ. I have the word of this gospel in my mouth and in my heart. I'm going to let the word, Christ Jesus, who is manifest in the flesh, be my Lord, rule over me. I'm going to let his written word be all that I believe, because you ain't figuring nothing out on your own. I'm going to tell you, everything you think up and everything, every conclusion that you come up with, it will be wrong. It would be wrong. You might believe it for a little while, but you'd probably be the only one to believe it. If it was sent out for peer review, everybody would probably just laugh. You have to spend a long time learning what everybody else learns and concluding what everybody else concludes before anybody's going to agree with you. Does that make sense? And then you're all together going to be found wrong. You see what I'm saying? Huh? Whole company of you going to be messed up. You're going to find out that ultimately where you've gotten yourself, where you've ended up, isn't the place that God has called you to be. Father tonight wants to take you up into a higher realm of relationship. And we say it's a higher realm of relationship. It's really just a relationship. What I mean by saying a higher realm of relationship, it's where you stay in relationship all the time. And the more you stay in relationship with them, the more wonderful you understand that he is, the more faithful you understand that he is, the more you understand that he is your redeemer, he is your savior, come save you from everything. Amen. Yeah. Master cares now that not that we perish. And immediately he rose up and saved them. Immediately, and that's just showing, and he did us then and now exactly what his response is always going to be. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Oh God, I don't want the fires never come out of my mouth. Say, Lord, let the fire burn. Mm-hmm. Oh, God, if I need to be in heaviness right now through many times of different tribulations, I thank you that you comfort me, because you, the God of all comfort, you, the encourager, you're encouraging me. You're telling me, be strong now in my own strength. I'm going to tell you right now, you have to be strong in this strength, because whether you like it or not, you engaged in a conflict and a war against, there's a war fighting against you, raging against you, and you're going to have to quit thinking their thoughts and living out their lie and participating with the world. world system that is going to leave you nothing but despairing, disappointed, and overwhelmed. God wants you to understand who you are. He's given you all power and authority in His name to go everywhere, having absolute ability to conquer and destroy every work of Satan, every work of darkness, removing out every hindrance from other people's lives that would try to prevent them from coming to know the Lord Jesus. But you and I are going to have to start off being first made partakers of this fruit, understanding how to walk around, being filled with the Spirit, living in the Spirit, being filled with the Holy Ghost, being filled with the parakletos, walking in the parakletos, huh? Living in the parakletos, being led by the parakletos. And somebody says, how do you translate parakletos, which is what we describe the Holy Ghost to be? Comforter, encourager, the one who gives you boldness, the one who fills you up with certainty, the one who gives you great confidence. Mm-hmm. Can't walk around without any confidence. You're not going to inherit the promise. You have to be very courageous. Huh? And you got to be willing to die. You got to be willing to die. But you know that the fact that is, I'm certain that Caleb was willing to die, but he knew that he was well able. He said, look, we're well able. We're well able to do this. Let us go up immediately at once, for we shall overcome it. Mm-hmm. What is it that you're facing? What is it that you're dealing with? What giant continually besets you? What thing continually robs your joy, takes away your peace, causes you discouragement, overwhelms you? What thing is going on in your life? People, I'm going to tell you right now, you need to do inventory. You need to understand the things that are going on in your life, the things that you've allowed in your life that can easily become a weapon against you. I mean, it's good to fast and to pray and break through into a realm where you can hear the Spirit of the Lord come. Comforting you. He's not accusing you. That is a realm of the demonic. Satan accuses you. God is comforting you. Huh?
Yeah, true.
I think one of the things people have the hardest time doing is crawling over top of their pride. Huh? They want to be so perfect. They want to be so good in their own self. Look, God isn't looking for me or you or anyone to do anything in their own self. In fact, He ain't accepting that kind of offering. Hey, you want to hear what He's got to say about it? No, you don't. He's not accepting a self-offering. He wants you and I, you know, I recognize we don't do it by might. We don't do it by strength. He says, cursed is every man who's trusting his own self.
True.
Looks to the arm of flesh, looks to his own provision. God's called you and I to live by the power of the Holy Ghost. And the evidence of living by the power of the Holy Ghost is we find a place where we, with just total abandonment, just throw our arms up to the Lord no matter what's going on. You know, I mean, you want to see faith at work? Here would be faith at work. There they are, Luke chapter 8, verse 24. There they are in the boat, Jesus sleeping, He's resting. They just throw their hands up into heaven and begin to praise the Lord, knowing that they can cast all of their cares on Him because He cares for them, knowing that they can be confidently kept safe in His hands. God has called you and I into a trust relationship that it doesn't matter what's going on. You and I know how to trust God. We know how to just completely give it over to Him. We know how to step away from worry. We know how to step away from anxiety. We don't sit there and try to figure out and try to find a solution, because we know at that very moment that now we're trying to trust in our own strength, that it's not by might, it's not by power, but it's by My Spirit, says the Lord. So I want to understand, how do I walk in the Holy Ghost? Jesus poured out this wonderful realm. You and I have these wonderful Holy Ghost meetings so that you can connect, not just so that you can feel good for a Sunday night or Wednesday night and feel a little bit of reprieve from all the battle weary feelings of whatever, you know. It is so that you and I are able to hook up and draw from all that strength which God gives, which is every dimension, all the fullness of His strength and all the fullness of His power and might. Because I'm telling you, your brain, your mind, your thoughts, your ways will deceive you. I'm telling you, it will play tricks on you. There's only one way for you to be kept, and that's to be kept by the power of God. There's only one way for you to understand clearly what you're supposed to do and how you're supposed to walk, and that is by giving all attendance unto the word of the Lord and having the word in your heart and in your mouth. That's the word of faith. To let your faith be effectual. In other words, let your faith go to work with the divine power of God by the acknowledgement of every good thing that is in you. Quit listening to the accusation. Quit listening to the slander. Quit listening to all of the lies. Quit listening to the threatening circumstances that says you're dead. Huh? And start moving rather in the relationship that God has given to us in the Holy Ghost. And I'm telling you, I believe with all of my heart, when you with a total with abandonment say, I don't care about any of these things, Lord. All that is important to me is your kingdom. All that is important to me is your will, Father. All that is important to me are the things that belong to that which you purchased for me at Calvary. Now you get to have everything. Now there's nothing attached to your heart or fixed to your heart anymore. You can receive an eviction notice and be cast out in the street and you walk around praising God. You could be beaten for your testimony of the Lord Jesus Christ and thrown in prison at midnight and walk around praising the Lord. Yeah. Hallelujah. I'm going to keep myself over here in the comfort. I'm going to keep myself over here in the encouragement. Hallelujah. I'm going to keep myself over here in the praise and in the thanksgiving and the joy and in the celebration. I'm not going to stop celebrating. Huh? If you see me stop celebrating, say, nudge me. Say, you're not celebrating. I'll get back over here. I'll get back over. So the Swiss scripture says, build up yourself in your most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. I'm going to build myself up. In other words, I'm going to strengthen myself. Somebody said, I'm not strong. Get strengthened then.
Amen.
Get strengthened because God wants to strengthen you. Quit trusting in yourself. Quit turning to your own self. Quit thinking about all the problems. Quit getting all emotionally wrapped up in the circumstance. Turn and look to God. Turn and look to Jesus, the author and finisher of your faith. He's there. He's going to complete everything. He's at work. He's molding you. You sang with me. You said it before. Yeah. Oh, God, break me.
Yep. True.
Don't sing that if you don't mean it. Because it's going to happen. Lord, break me. Melt me. Ooh. Don't say that unless you're ready. But I tell you, it's good because he's going to fashion us and prepare us unto every good work so that you and I can find ourselves doing all these wonderful, glorious things that God has allowed his redeemed, those who have inherited from him to do. There's nothing like living in this divine glory, having the ministry of angels in our lives, having Christ Jesus there as the master of our soul, as the savior of everything about every dimension of our lives. There's nothing like having authority over demon spirits, speaking and calling it out in faith and seeing a work being produced and done that will last till Jesus comes and beyond. There's nothing like ruling and reigning with him, standing in a place of divine power and authority, speaking in his name and seeing the yoke broken, diseases having to fall off people, deaf and blindness, halt and lame, bound up by demon power and shame, broken in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. Just the way of the redeemed is the way which we live. Unless we are unwise and are wrapped up in the cares of this life, you cannot please him who has called you to be a soldier when you are wrapped up and entangled with the affairs of this life. I shall not be entangled with the affairs of this life. If you're continually having problems and you don't know the remedy, I've got your answer tonight. You've entangled yourself with the affairs of this life. Break free of it and let God begin to promote you into that wonderful realm of divine rulership, friendship, relationship, glorificationship. Because he's not only justified us together with them, he has glorified us right this moment, right now. It's a shock to theology. Romans 8:32 is a head scratcher. Not to me. Hallelujah. Why? Because he poured out the Holy Ghost. And I recognize that I believe I have interacted it. I have come into a place of knowing him. So therefore, I'm not going to ignore his companionship. I'm not going to ignore what he wants to give me, what he wants to do through me. I'm going to connect with him according to those things which the Lord has spoken, such as building myself up
in my most holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Is absolutely foreign to the natural mind, but it will take you into a place of glory and joy divine. It will cause you to be raptured into a realm of divine authority to speak faith and never say again, Master, carest thou not? Don't you even care? Can't you even see me? Aren't you aware? Father, I pray right now in Jesus' name that your people will be able to see clearly the battle that is before them and understand that you have equipped them and given them each one more power, more ability, more strength than they'll ever even need. There is a surplus. I tell you, there is a surplus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You know, there's such a surplus that when it comes right down to it, when it's time to bind Satan and his angels, Jesus ain't going to even dirty his hands. He ain't gonna even put forth any effort. He's going to send one angel. I would imagine it's going to be the smallest, littlest angel in the kingdom. It ain't going to be the big angel. You don't need no big angel. The smallest sized angel in the kingdom. He's going to go with one chain and he's going to bind Satan and all of his armies in the lake of fire. Hallelujah. For 1,000 years. Hallelujah. And then he made you and I the redeemed, the people that he walks around in, the people that he talks through, the people that he's going to execute his will through. You're going to have to do inventory of your life and define how much stuff that is in this world rules over your mind. Find out how many things that belong to a place that is really a demonic realm is allowed to influence you. They begin to deal with how much care you have for yourself. And that's why the Lord knows how the life works that he designed. He's the designer of it. He tells us very clearly based upon the situation and condition we find ourselves in now. He says, these are the things you're going to have to do if you're going to walk with me and I'm going to be able to bless you.
That's what he tells us.
If I'm going to be able to use you, if I'm going to be able to flow through you, if I'm going to be able to strengthen you, if I'm going to be able to empower you, these are the things you're going to have to do. And he makes it very simple things. It's really just comes down to things like love me with everything that is within your heart. Understand that the most important thing that is needful for your life is to take a hold of everything that I have that I've freely given to you so that you can know this life. And you can't have it as long as you're preoccupied by what you're going to eat. Give me a break. Your life is more meaningful than what you're going to eat for breakfast. I mean, I've heard people reduce it down to this and say, well, you know, we all got to go to work. We all got to eat. I mean, goodness, can you come up with a little bit loftier goal for working? But I don't believe that. Why? I don't believe that. I believe that what Jesus said is true. Take no thought of it. Papa will feed you.
Hallelujah.
I don't believe I've got to feed myself. I don't believe that. I believe that God is my God and that I am one of his people, that I am his people. I believe that all of his delights are with me. I believe that everything that is good, everything that is perfect, and everything that belongs to his riches and everything that belongs to his glory is mine.
Amen.
And yet, what happens is every one of us to some degree, if we're not mindful, if we're not willing to be watchful, if we're not willing to be filled with the Spirit, are going to allow some kind or manner of influence of the cares of selfish interest to hold us back from all that Father wants to liberally give us. You're walking into this inheritance with total abandonment and total trust, just like the children of Israel were going to in the day when they were in the wilderness and God gave them the opportunity and only 2 men out of 3 million. Those aren't good statistics. Are you 2 out of 3 million? 2 out of 3 million, I mean, you know, if you kept that proportionality, that wouldn't be very many today, would it?
2 out of 3 million? Huh? 20 out of 30 million? 200 out of 300 million? Right? And so on. 2,000 out of 3 billion? Right? Would I, huh? Where am I at now? 3 billion would end up how many? That's how many zeros? Is that 20? I'm not in that realm. I'm not in the calculation realm. I'm in another realm. But you know what I mean. The statistics aren't very good. The bigger question is not whether you could do the math. It's whether you could go into the inheritance. Huh? It's whether or not you're willing to just with total abandonment say, okay, yeah, this is going to cost me everything. I have to believe in things that I can't calculate. I got to believe in things that I can't quantitate. I got to believe in things that I cannot see, that I cannot measure in any way. I got to believe in just a word that I've received from heaven. That's all I've got to go on. If I begin to think about it, if I begin to consider it, I'm going to immediately conclude that we can't do it. All the other guys, the 3 million, they were smart. The 2, they were stupid. From the perspective of men, the 2 were absolutely mindless, unthinking, not willing to evaluate what's really going on. The 3 million, they were the bright folks. And the bright folks can't enter into the things of God, cannot receive the things of God. The intellect and the natural thinking of men separated from it. God, what God says is foolishness to the natural mind. What do you? That's foolish. That's foolish. That's foolish. They got. Are you kidding me? They got iron chariots. These are men of war from their childhood. They outnumber us. How many? Who knows? I mean, there was a great number of host of these. A great host of these people. What are you going to do? Are you going to measure your life based upon the things that you are going, are you able to accomplish? Are you willing to, with total abandonment, believe that God has empowered you and now take a hold of a relationship that is the means by which you're now able to walk in the faith that produces the mountain, that removes the mountains out of the way, that produces the miracles? I'm going to tell you right now, you listen to me, this kind of faith many times is only going to come by prayer and fasting. Why? Because you've been God's people, the people that have come out of the world and come in to this place called the kingdom of the dear son are trying to walk in with a bunch of former conversation and a bunch of ideas and values that they gained from a demonic world, from a world system, from a human behavioral point of view. And now the Lord's saying to us, you can't come in here with that. You're going to have to leave it outside. The former conversation you're going to have to put away from you. There's a new value system that you're going to have to take care of it. And there's a new value system that you're going to have to promote as the most important thing to you. You're going to have to let my word of life rule over you. It's going to have to be in you and on your lips. It can't depart out of your mouth or the mouth of your seed so that you may be able to do what I've told you to do and inherit the things that I've given you. And it's God the Holy Ghost that's given us the encouragement saying, you can do this. I said you can do it. I'm telling you, you can do it. I want you to know, don't worry about all that stuff. Here, let me comfort you some. I'm your helper. I'm here to help you. When somebody said, we need some help. Guess what? You have the most help you could possibly ever imagine. There's more with you than are with them. There is a great company around about you right now. Amen. And even if there weren't, all you need is God the Holy Ghost because He's God. Amen. Who will believe our report? To these then will the arm of the Lord be revealed to. We've got to realize that without faith it's impossible to please God. Father wants to see a development and a growth and a maturation of mountain moving faith in our lives. And He says there's one way. And really, when you take and you begin to evaluate all the different attributes of how faith works, it really comes down to a relationship with the Lord Jesus. It comes down to a real living relationship with the Holy Spirit. Huh? Mm-hmm. I don't need music to worship. I don't need a guitar, a piano, a keyboard, a violin, an orchestra, nothing. Give me just, I've got everything that I need to worship. He gave it to me. He created me for His praise. And there's something so wonderful about what happens when you and I turn from the circumstances of life and begin to worship Him and begin to praise Him and begin to give thanks and say, Lord, I trust You. Whether I live or whether I die, I trust You. All I want is You. Whether there is food, it does not matter. Whether there's a calf in the stall, where there's fruit on the vine. And that's, you know, when Habakkuk's saying that, he's talking about the grocery store that they had at that time. So he says, whether there's any food in the grocery store, it's equivalent. Whether there's a calf in the stall or fruit in the vine, what does it matter? Whether people are making merry or not, it does not matter. There can be none of it. There can be no calf. There can be no fruit. There can be no merrymaking. Still, I'm going to rejoice. He found a relationship. Dear people of God, if there's anything that we need in this day, in this hour, is we need people who step into a more viable relationship, a deeper relationship that will cause them to know their God so they'll never ask again, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Aren't you aware of our situation? Don't you just see me sitting here all upset, all overwhelmed? Well, when your heart is overwhelmed, you should immediately understand that God is there to lead you. God is there. When my heart is overwhelmed, I come into this place in Him, and I live in this place in Him. I come to the meeting tonight. You come to the meeting tonight, I hope, for one reason, so that you may obtain help. So that you can have help for time of need. People want to wait till the time of need, and then they're completely overwhelmed by the circumstance and situation and the doubt and the unbelief. I'm telling you right now, you are absolutely not in a state to be able to even begin to move forward in what God has for you. You missed your opportunity to be strengthened by the Spirit in your inner being. Oh, don't do that anymore. Don't do that anymore. Mm-hmm. I mean, don't do that anymore. It's some nagging thought of sadness and sorrow and defeat and disappointment and some overwhelming concept of how you're not going to be able to make it, or it's too much, or you can't go on, or some weary thought that would try to cause you to faint begins to work. Understand, it's the enemy of your soul. It's a lying thing that the slanderer, Satan, is speaking. Don't live in that word. That is terrible. Come on out over here. Hear the word of the Lord. Believe what He said about you. Believe about you. Believe His love for you. Believe that He's going to take good care of you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Believe that He's going to provide for you according to His riches and glory. Believe, and with total abandonment. And in fact, if it is, Lord, I love You so much. I'm just so happy being with You. It doesn't matter. I just want You. I don't need these things. You know, Jesus looks at Peter and says, Peter, do you love Me more than these? And He looks at me and He asks me, Mark, do you love Me more than these? And what was He talking about? He was talking about the means by which Peter was able to take care of himself and his family. It wasn't just fishies in the sea. It was the means. It was his livelihood. It was the means by which he provided for himself. It was his livelihood. It was his trade. It was the trade of his father, his grandfather, his great-grandfather. Who knows how long? That's the way they made their living. And Jesus said, do you love Me more than the way you make your living? Do you love Me more than the way you provide for yourself? Do you love Me more than the way that you have learned how to trust in the things that you can do? That's what he said. Do you love Me more than these? And Peter said, yeah. And then Jesus said, do you love Me more than these? Do you love Me more than the things that you can do to take care of yourself? Where you're taking thought for what you shall eat and what you shall wear. Do you love Me enough to trust Me? Do you love Me enough to throw in completely on Me? Do you love Me enough to go to the cross and die for Me? Because he was really saying that all in the same context. He's saying that, you've basically lived your life. You've gone wherever you wanted to go. And what's going to happen is you're turning your life over to Me now here, and you're going to be led to a place you don't want to go. Speaking of what death, he was going to die. And according to church history, You know, Peter was crucified upside down. People are too happy in their living rooms. People are too earnest about how they're going to, you know, have another, you know, whatever, massage and manicure or whatever it is that they do. How they're going to have more, you know, cush and fluff and whatever. Jesus says to you and me, deny yourself, take up your cross and follow me. In China, in Asia, when people come into the kingdom, they come into the kingdom being told by their leaders, your life is over. You are now going to go die somewhere. Where do you want to go to die? Okay, there's also some places you can go to prison. There's some prison options over here in Asia and over here in the Middle East. And then you could just, a couple countries you could go ahead and die in right now. So immediately their life is over. Their assignment is take up their cross and follow Jesus. That's it. That's what they're told to do. Go. Where are you going to go and die for Jesus? Where are you going to go live as a living martyr or die for him? In America, we're not told that. We're told different things. But they're told exactly what Jesus said. He said, lay down your life. He tells us very clearly, we no longer live. It's now Christ that's living. He's called us to a place of giving ourselves over to do whatever it is he's called us to do. And for the most part, like in China, many of the people, they have to leave their mother and their father. They have to leave their family because the child is the only hope of the family, because you're allowed one child. And now this child is telling you that they're going to go give their life in service for Jesus. What a terrible defeat to the family pride. And so now they're an outcast. What are you? What is it that you're in the struggles with right now? When it's compared to being willing to obey and go all the way with God like that. I want you to know today, I want you to know tonight, that if you're just simply willing to sign up to go all the way with God, if you're willing to lay your life down from this day forward and not to be entangled with the affairs of this life, to leave everything behind, to take up your cross and follow him, to deny yourself, all your problems will immediately come to an end. And you will find a great comfort. And you will find a great encouragement. And you'll find great consolation. You'll find great change in your life. You'll find the joy of the Holy Ghost and a fellowship with him. And you know, you may not even have to leave your job. You may not. It's just that you're going to have a different attitude about your job. Right. You may, God may actually keep you right in the same workplace you're in. It's just that you won't have the same attitude about your workplace and about your check and about all the other things that's been bothering you and concerning you and the promotion, your career, and what you're going to do with your life. Let me tell you what you do with your life. You're going to go lay down your life somewhere for Jesus Christ. That's what you're going to do with your life. Now let's settle it.
Amen.
Your career is to fully live for him and glorify him, whether by your life or by your death. That's it. You're done. Amen. He has given to us very clearly our assignment of what we're supposed to do. Yeah. His love compels me. His love compels me. For we know that Christ suffered and died for all of us. He died for us. We understand that we no longer live. From this day forward, knowing that he died for us because we were all dead, and now we no longer live unto ourselves but to him. You had to stop your problems, your suffering, your crying, your sorrow, your discouragement, your disappointments, not his. Those will end when all of a sudden you don't live for yourself anymore. You understand in a fundamental, practical way how to deny that thing every day. Mm-hmm. How, in other words, when you deny something, you say no to it. You have no place in my life. You know, I'm not thinking your thoughts. I'm not living in your interest. I'm not coming under the defeat of your concerns. Hallelujah. Mm-hmm. I'd rather turn my heart towards heaven. I now live in a place where I'm fully living for him. Yes. He lives in me. I have all heaven now on my side. And the Lord looks at you and he says, do you love me more than what you're doing? Do you love me more than what you trust in to provide for your daily bread? Do you love me more than what you trust in to take care of your housing? Do you love, how many of you ready? Right now, you ready? You're ready to sell everything and come follow Jesus. Yes. To sell it all. Yeah. Give it to the poor and come follow Jesus. Mm-hmm. Huh? Mm-hmm. I got a bunch of places you can go right now and give your life. And thousands of people will ultimately come into the kingdom. There's so many hungry people in right now in third world countries. So many hungry people. The world's coming. The world's coming unglued. It's coming unraveled. It's going to get worse. We know in the last days that there will be every man will set his hand against his neighbor. There'll be civil war and social unrest and conflict everywhere. And we already understand that. It's already been told and revealed to us by the Lord. And out of the midst of that, there's going to come at one point in time one who's going to supposedly bring the hope of peace. And the world's heart will be turned towards him. He's called the Antichrist. We know that the world is coming unraveled. We look at it. You know, it is amazing to me all the things that are going on, the great social and civil unrest that's going on in Turkey right now, that's going on in Greece right now, that's not just going on in the Ukraine, it's going on other satellite nations around Russia. And we don't get nothing of it. We're gonna sit and listen over and again ad infinitum about some plane they can't find. You know, it's quite confusing, the world that we live in. And if you under the influence of that, and if you believe all of those things that are being told to you over the airwaves and communicated to you via the internet or whatever, you're just lost. You're blind and cannot see. There's only one light. There's only one means by which we can understand where we're going and how to get there. It's the Word of God. And the Holy Spirit Himself, the Parakletos, has come. The Parakalo, the Parakletos has come. The Holy Spirit, the Comforter, the Encourager, the one who emboldens us, the one who gives us a great confidence. And then out of that, He gives us a great joy. I can be glad because He's made me glad. I can rejoice in all my tribulation because He's made me glad. Amen. I can count it all joy because I know that God's preparing me and He's forming me. I know that my faith will be found in the praise and honor and glory that's appearing. If a nuclear bomb was to come and explode right here, right now in San Diego, I'm fine. I'm going straight up. I'm happy as a clam at high tide. Better than that, I'm happy as a saint in heaven. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Praise God. Amen. Huh? What is it that you're holding on to? Whatever you're holding on to may hold on to you when the trumpet sounds. Whatever you're holding on to may hold on to you when God calls you to be accounted or give an account for your life. Don't hold on to those things no more.
Amen.
Because the Lord says that those things will choke you and you will not be able to bring forth fruit. And He tells us the classification that He puts people in that do not bring forth fruit. Hear the warning. Hear my cry. Hear my passion. Hear my plea. This is not something different from what the Word of God says. This is the Word of God. People act like that God's just going to be, you know, He's going to allow unruliness and rebellion and stubbornness and self-interest to continue on. And that because He loves us so much, He's just going to allow it to go on. That's not true. He even says, if you're lukewarm, I won't have fellowship with you. Come on now. Huh? That shouldn't bring discouragement to you. That should bring resolve to you.
Amen.
Amen. So I'm going to have fellowship. I'm not going to be lukewarm. I'm going to walk in obedience. Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to walk in the encouragement and the comfort. I'm going to be built up in the faith.
Amen.
I'm going to be strengthened by the Spirit in my inner being.
Amen.
I'm going to be strong in the strength of the Lord, because there's no other way to be strong in the strength of the Lord other than to be strengthened by the Spirit in your inner being.
Right.
Paul set that up in Ephesians 3:16 to be able to tell us Ephesians 6:10. Oh, dear people, you got to understand the things that are going on in this world, the things that so many people have bought into. I'm telling you right now, there are more tricks of Satan going down. There is more wicked influences going down in the midst of the church and among God's people than probably at any time. There is more problems going on that your kids are faced with, more social pressures that your kids are faced with in school than ever before. The whole gamut. What are you going to do? Are you going to bow every day to the God of money? Are you going to bow every day to the God of your career? Are you going to bow every day to God of these things? Because Jesus said, you cannot serve mammon and me. You cannot serve mammon and God. You cannot serve the self-interest of this world, no matter how you flower it up, no matter what kind of nice little uniform you put on it, no matter what kind of makeup you put on it. He will choke you so that you cannot bring forth fruit.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. And we know what the Lord Jesus says about not bringing forth fruit. He says, if you don't bring forth fruit, you will wither. You will fall. And you'll be gathered up of men. Men will gather you up. Men, the men that you serve will be the men that ruin you. The earthly interests that have consumed you will be the earth that swallows you. Hear the warning. Because man doesn't have the ability to live a compromised life and still ultimately make the right decisions. God has shown us that it's absolutely all or nothing. You can't add to the word, because if you do, ultimately deception is going to come and take hold of you, and the plagues of the book will be added to you. You can't take away from it, because ultimately deception will take hold of you and your name will be taken from the book of life. People, you can't run that risk. We can't run that risk. Come on, man. Let everything that we're doing somehow be deposited into the kingdom of God, somehow to go everywhere reaching the lost. I'm telling you, people are dying by the millions every day, the tens of millions continually on the way to an eternity without God, while we're all consumed with whatever problems we've got.
The world's much bigger than you.
The world's much bigger than your little universe of what's going on around your life, and your what makes you sad, what makes you happy, what you taste good to you, what tastes bad to you, how comfortable your bed is, how new your couch is, whatever that's got you perplexed. There is no end to that realm of dissatisfaction. There is no realm into it. The self realm is impossible to fully gratify. You will be a slave to yourself, never being able to find rest. When all the time, Christ Jesus says, all you who are labored, heavy laden, come to me, I'll give you rest. People look at us and they say, money, money, money. They see dollar bills. Oh, I can make a bunch of money off of you. Tell you what, I'm gonna give you a raise, but I want you to work more for me. I'm not for sale. No. I'm not for sale. I'll pray about it, but I'm not for sale. If I can see a way to advance the kingdom of God and God will give me liberty, I might continue to work here. I'm not bowing to your music. I'm not bowing to your noise. I'm not bowing to your threats. I'm not bowing to your demands. I will alone serve God and bow before Him and Him alone. Doesn't matter what you do to me. Doesn't matter what threats there are. Are you going to lose your house? You're going to be poor? You're going to live out on the streets? No, I live out in the woods. And I want to live out in the woods because Papa said something that's far, far more valid than all the threats of men and everything that society and everything that the system says. He said, you throw it all in me and I'm going to take better care of you than Solomon.
That's what he said. Mm-hmm. True.
And we hold back because we just can't trust him that far. Because we can't calculate it. We can't see it. We can't measure it. We can't quantify it. We can't quantitate it. It don't make any sense. The wisdom of God's foolishness to men. But the height of men's wisdom is foolishness to God. The height of men's calculations, all it is vanity and vexation of spirit. It will profit you nothing. And if you ultimately find security in it, God will say, you fool, this day shall your soul be required of you. That's what the Papa says. That's what our Heavenly Father says. Come on now. Come on now. Come on now. Come on now. Mans dengi brudana manjesi ti kota alapaya. Hale bibrista avrataya. Nem belengdato yevrataya. Nem bembrista radala bekete. Imbrevetuya. I'm involved in a company right now. Daniel and I, we work in a company right now because we see a means by which we can lay hold on finances for the kingdom of God. And since we got involved in the company's shooting straight up. Yeah. And we claiming the prophet to go do things in crusade evangelism and in orphanages and ministry, not only here in the United States of America, but everywhere God will open up the door in the world. That's all I'm going to spend my time on. Otherwise, I'm just going to go stand out there and preach somewhere. I'm not going to spin my wheels. I'm not going to look like in any way, any form or shape like Samson with his hair cut off, his eye plucked out, going round and round and round, getting nowhere, spinning round and stop. Get off the merry-go-round, man, because it's not a merry-go-round. It's a sad go-round. Get off of the thing, man. If what you're doing is not making money for the kingdom of God and advancing the cause of Christ Jesus, then I'm telling you right now, sell everything that you have and we'll help send you out someplace into one of the nations of the world. Just come see me after the meeting. We've got calls right now for help to come. Well, every one of you, you vitally important. You can be used in amazing ways on the foreign mission field right now. You'll have crowds of people coming to your meetings. Get ready to go. You decide whether or not you can handle living in this society. Huh? If you can't handle living in this society, if the idols of this society are too big for you, get out of this thing now. Huh? It's like talking to an alcoholic that can't stay away from the booze. Man, I'm going to tell you right now, you're going to have to get away. You can't go into the bars anymore. You can't go into the grocery stores anymore that have that. You're going to have to get yourself isolated until you're strong enough to be able to go around it or get near it and pass on by it and not partake. Huh? If you can't handle living in this culture and keeping your eyes set on Jesus, if you continually be entrapped and entangled and ensnared, leave this society. Take up your cross and go follow Jesus in a third world country where you're blessed to have, you know, daily provision. Father promises he'll take good care of you out there on the mission field, so don't worry. You'll be taken care of. You might be killed, but don't worry, that's promotion. It's promotion. That's right. There's some places right now that need you, that need us, but you'll just die. You'll die, you'll be in prison, or you'll die. But is that something that's unique? No, because tonight, right now, there's tens of thousands, there's just more than can be counted of God's people that are right now suffering in prison for the sake of the gospel, that are on death row right now for preaching because they just won't stop preaching. Right now in North Korea, there's about a dozen people about ready to be executed for preaching the gospel. Wondering what they're doing. Wonder if they're worried about the mortgage. Huh? Wonder if they're concerned about the promotion at work. Huh? Wonder if they're concerned about what new set of clothes they're going to get. They just tired of wearing the rags they bought last month. And they hadn't had a new pair of shoes for 2 weeks. You know what I'm saying? Kind of thing. You with me? That's really our big. These are our big concerns. I'm embarrassed. I can't go to church because I've worn these shoes now 3 times, and everybody's going to recognize that this would be the 4th time wearing these shoes, and I just can't go to the meeting. What do you call that? Say it's not true. Yeah, it's true. And there's various different degrees of that manifested in our life. Our performance. I don't have performance. Nothing. Everything I got's a grace that's been given to me. Has nothing to do with me. I want nothing to do with me. I have nothing of myself. Huh? I count it all loss. Huh? Hallelujah. The only thing I want anything to do with is Christ in me. He's changed me. I belong to him. I'm not my own. I belong. He can do with me whatever he wants to. He looks at me and says, do you love me more than these? I said, yes, Lord. He says, the second time, you love me more than these? I said, yes, Lord. Third time. And it's like, oh, really? Really? Really, do you love me more than these? And Peter says, Lord, you know everything. You know I love you more than these. What does he say? He says, go feed my sheep then. Go preach the gospel. Go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. How much goes on right now? I'm going to give you something. I'm going to challenge you tonight. How much is the God of this world able to influence you and intimidate you? How many times do you get to share about who Jesus is, but you're intimidated and you're fearful and you don't know how to start? That is a measure of how much you are intimidated and influenced by the God of this world. That is just one of the measures, just one of many measures. And I believe it's very important. There's a lot of folks that don't like me talking about the truth and making things real practical and real apparent. But I believe in very clearly evaluating where we are at and where we versus where we need to be and what we need to be doing. It's really high time, people, that we just stop living for ourselves. Amen. Hallelujah. It's high time that we begin to trust God. And we begin to adorn His house with glorious things and glorious apparel and bringing Him our best, to where that there's always plenty of everything, plenty of musicians, plenty of singers, plenty of worshipers, plenty of rejoicers, plenty of shouters, plenty of prophesiers, plenty of those who are filled up with God have plenty to give, for they've received more than enough from heaven. Hallelujah. They can share it. They can send portions to those who have none. Amen. Hallelujah. Master, carest thou not that we perish? Where is your faith? They're bewildered. They still don't believe. They still can't even imagine. Still beyond their comprehension. Even though they've seen all the miracles, even though that there's a revelation that's come to them, still they're going, what manner of man is this? That even the wind and the waves obey him? That's us. We're still kind of figuring it out. God, really? Oh yeah, he's God. Yeah, he's God. Really? Because if he's God, no problem with him being able to command the wind and the waves. And Nathaniel was there, Bartholomew, who said, my Lord and my God. Really? Master, carest thou not that we perish? What manner of man is this? Is Christ Jesus the same Christ Jesus that was there with the 12 that night in the boat? Is he with you right now? The faith is that you know that he is. If you're having problems with that, I'm going to tell you what's going on. There's things in your life that are keeping you from seeing. It's not God's fault. He's given abundance of wisdom, abundance of insight, abundance of revelation. But there's things that you brought from the former conversation. There's things that you brought from the influences of the world that you've accepted as okay and right, and you've tried to bring them along, and the Lord says, you're not moving forward. You're going to be in trouble. You're going to be in heaviness. You're going to be heaviness until this thing gets right. That the trying of your faith, which is much more precious than gold. Huh? Hallelujah. 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 God, bro, you've received, you know, Peter Comfort says, he says, you received your salvation, but you're in trouble. You're in heaviness right now, if need be. You've got to understand, those things can't come with you. That former conversation can't come with you. Those interests, those lies, those doubts, those unbeliefs, they've got to be removed from out of your life. And here's the process by which they shall be removed. Hallelujah. So you can count it all joy, because you're getting rid of baggage. You can count on joy because you're getting rid of the problem now. You can count on joy because you're getting rid of the stuff that's been causing, haunting you and causing you setback after setback. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You're getting rid of the issues wherein Satan has been able to access you. Hallelujah. Because there's a place you can walk where he can't access you. There's a place where you can walk where he can't touch you. Hallelujah. I love that realm. I love this authority over demon spirits. I love this place of fellowship with him. I love the idea and the notion, just thinking about right now, the opportunities in the next few years of going on the stage of various different places in the world and seeing whole nations turn to Jesus because of great signs and wonders. Yeah. I tell you what I love the most of all
as I love the manifest glory and the manifest anointing that is there. Okay, it cost $150,000 to have one of the greatest crusades, the greatest crusade. It has not been surpassed. The greatest crusade that the nation of Nepal has ever seen. It cost $150,000. That's cheap.
Yeah. That was cheap. That was really inexpensive. It truly was.
Because the total amount of people that were influenced, that's probably a dollar a head. Come on, man. Huh? And I'm seeing the Lord just taking us to build us up to be able to do more. I mean, I was listening to Reinhardt the other night talking about 55 million people that has come to the Lord in the Crusades in Africa. And I know the fire that he's been through. I know the trying of his faith that he's been through. I know the decisions and the crossroads where he said, I don't care. All for you, Lord Jesus. I resign myself completely to your will. I know what it took. I know that every day you and I, wherever we're at, wherever the dimension of our relationship exists right now, we are making the same kind of decisions. The impact may not be as big right now, but it's ultimately the step that leads to that place where you can make, where the impact will be big. Right now, the things, the troubles, the issues you're going through, you have to be able to say, I care not for these things. All for you, Lord Jesus, I will not be moved. Like a tree planted by the water, I shall not be moved. I shall not be moved. Huh? It's the decision of a heart. It's the decision of a will. I'm looking forward to the day in the not too distant future to begin to see even greater opportunities in the United States of America. Reinhardt said that the Lord has showed him to start doing crusades in America. He just started them up. And start going from one city after another until it builds to the point that stadiums are filled. It's a realm of faith. Oh, Rabastikita. It's a realm of faith that comes from the fact that you've been willing to go through the fiery trial. It comes from the faith because you've been willing to be prepared. It comes from the faith because you're saying, break me, melt me, mold me. Shape me, fill me. And he did so, and you enjoyed, you counted all joy being broken, counted it all joy being melted, counted all joy being molded, counted all joy being filled. Hallelujah. And it is joy being filled. It ain't so much seeming joy when you're being broken. Huh? But I'm telling you right now, you can get right into the joy in the breaking process. Hallelujah. You can walk around rejoicing in the midst of the prison and the darkness of the hour. In the sorrow of the circumstance that has come and overwhelmed your heart. Hallelujah. God is in our midst. He is real. He is present. He is living. He is God. He can in a moment, in an instant, at any time that he wants to, give you every resource, translate you to any place, empower you to do the things that go beyond and defy the imagination. He empowered a man who was willing to be shaped in the crucible of faith. Reinhardt Bonnke, result, 55 million people. Never in the world had it been heard of or known or thought that many people could be in one crusade. As many as he had over and over and again. What will you do? What will you sell your soul for? What will you sell your soul for? What will you give your exchange your life for? Will you exchange your life for Christ Jesus? Will you be bought with his blood to live only for him? Or will you continue in your self-interest? You'll be able to tell real quickly. It will ultimately result in what you are limited to do, what you're able to do, what you're not able to do, how much joy you have, how much influence you have, how much anointing, how much prayer, how much call you have. I mean, to get down on your knees and begin to cry out to God, how you're drawn into His presence when no one else can see you, how hungry and thirsty you are for the things that the Word of God is ministering, that the Spirit of God is teaching. It becomes all-consuming, a fire that burns within your life where you can't get enough, and you begin to burn with the glory of God. I don't care if you're a 90-year-old woman somewhere in a house way back out in the wilderness. I'm telling you, you touch heaven, heaven will touch you. You will burn with the glory of God and be used and never leave your living room. And everybody will know. Everybody will be able to see it. And one day, it'll be shouted from the housetops. Because when you step into this kind of faith and this kind of relationship, you are not limited by your circumstances. You're not limited by your age. You're not limited by how much money you have. Nothing limits you. There's too many people that have been contented just to have a little bit of God. That's called religion. A little bit of prayer. They don't know how to touch heaven. I'm here to provoke you to good works. I'm here to say, listen, it's time for you to touch heaven. People say, all you're doing is discouraging me now. No, I'm calling you to the best thing you could possibly ever want. Yeah. Is it discouragement to say, hey, there's $1 billion over here for you? Why are you sitting there? Huh? Is that discouragement? I don't say that's discouragement. No. I say that's a hello. Yeah. Come on now.
Amen. That's free.
It's only discouragement because you don't want to get up and move. You want it brought to you where you're sitting. Well, we bring it to you where you're sitting, you'll sit there with it. When somebody else could have received it and used it. But the thing about it is, God's going to hold you responsible in a greater way for sitting there with it. Huh? He's going to only give it to those who are moving. Yeah. Look, I'm going to be moving.
Yes.
I'm moving. Amen. I'm going to move. Amen. I'm going to continue to move. Yes. I'm going to continue to deposit everything I have into the bank account of heaven. I'm going to continue to put my treasure of my heart and of my life. I'm calling you, God's calling you people. The Lord has given us a window of time.
Yes.
And great is the battle. Mm. How many have been fit for the battle? I'm fit for the battle.
Amen.
I've been prepared unto this day. I'm fit for it. I know what I'm up against. I've been here before. God would raise up people who know how to be valiant, full of valor, strong, bold, very courageous, brave, unmovable. Go ahead, heat the thing up 7 times harder. I don't care. It doesn't matter to me whether I live or whether I die. Go ahead. Throw me in that thing where all those hungry lions are. It doesn't matter. Just throw me in. I'm not changing. I'm going to obey God.
Mm-hmm. Hallelujah.
What bravery. What comfort. In other words, what encouragement. What boldness. What certainty. What confidence. What assurance. This is what the Holy Ghost has come to give us. Let Him minister to you. Let Him touch you. Let Him fill you. So boko nan gade. Don't make decisions based upon your money. Don't make decisions based upon your own strength and your own ability and what you think you can do. Make decisions on what God said go and do. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Make decisions on what Christ Jesus has plainly modeled for us. Hallelujah. And spoken to us. He's taken us. He's shown us how to go to the mountain of prayer and pray all night. He showed us how to continue in prayer. He showed us how to continue and being instant continually in the things of the Spirit. He showed us how to continually walk there. Mm-hmm. Somebody said, well, I don't know. I just don't seem to have a great desire. I understand. It's all been zapped out of you by the cares of this life. Because you entangled with the world. It chokes you. You can't have the fruit of hunger. You can't have the fruit of thirsting. You can't have those fundamental deep desires that draw you into a place of prayer for long hours. And you love it. It is not a labor. It's not a burden. It's a place of rest. It's a place of strengthening. It's a place of refreshing. I could just feel my wife over there throughout the night last night praying. She would sleep. She's over there praying. She had things she's just getting through. It's nighttime, but she's there. She's instead of in the living room, she's in bed because she doesn't want to disturb me. Man, that's fine. That's good to respond, the sensitivity to the Father. He's given us his heart to want to know him. The cry of the Son is inside of us saying, oh, Abba, Father, Father. Well, but I understand. Those things can be choked. They can be, as it were, shut off unless you and I understand how to renounce the things of this world. Renounce the things of self. Be crucified to the world. It has no career for me. It has no opportunity for me. I do not find my home here. I do not find my life here. I don't find nothing here. Huh? I'm not interested in retiring. Hallelujah. I'm interested in advancing. I'm interested in preaching the gospel fully. To not let up in any way. To die preaching. Praise God. That's my retirement plan. My retirement plan is leave this life and go into the next. I can see it. I already see it now. Somewhere I'm preaching and I see the angels visibly, physically coming to get me. And I know I'm getting ready to die. Here they come. They're coming to get me. But I'm going to get a couple more sentences in. I'm going to get a couple more points. Hallelujah. Peter says, so long as I'm in this tabernacle, I will continue to stir you up by putting you in remembrance of these things. Those were very important things that he listed. And I'm going to close tonight reading them. In 1 Peter, 2 Peter, forgive me, chapter 1. I say take this whole world, but give me Jesus. Huh?
Yes, sir.
Hallelujah. I say I have no pleasure in this world. I hate my life in this world. I'm going to say it like Jesus said it. I'm going to go ahead and be radical. I'm going to go ahead and be radical with me. I hate my life in this world. I don't want my life in this world. I want his life. I see nothing beautiful or valuable or good about living out my life in this world. I want his life. And that's beautiful and that's glorious. And his life is unmistakable because he's the same yesterday, today, and forever. And his life is doing exactly what he did then. And I'm going to get with it. And you need to get with it too. Huh? Some dimension of it. Maybe God gives you the dimension of just the prayer life that Jesus had. Maybe God gives you the dimension of the ministry life, the evangelism life that Jesus had. Maybe God gives you the dimension of the prophet life that Jesus had. Maybe God gives you the dimension of the teacher life that Jesus had. Maybe God gives you the dimension of the healing life that Jesus had. Maybe God gives you the ministry of the miracle life that Jesus had. Maybe the Lord gives you every dimension of the fullness of the ministry of the life that Jesus had. How much do you want? Oh, I just want a little bit. You know, it's like people come to me and start talking to me. Well, do all speak with tongues? Like they're trying to find an excuse not to have that gift. Well, Paul said, Paul asked a rhetorical question, do all speak with tongues? You notice he didn't say, no. He certainly said you may all prophesy. And we certainly do understand what Paul believed about the gift of tongues and the ministry of the Holy Ghost. We understand that. Have you received the Holy Ghost since you believed? Immediately he laid hands on them and they all began to speak with tongues. Uh-huh. It's amazing what people try to do to get out of these wonderful blessings that God has for us. These wonderful gifts that Father has for us.
Huh? I want more. Huh? Little Anna at her party, she didn't really feel like eating any cookies, but she wanted to be able to claim some, so she walked around licking them all. She wanted to participate, so she licked all the cookies. They all belonged to her after that. I'll take some of it all. It's just laying there anyway. I just claim it all as mine. Hallelujah. Dear people, God loves you. He set his affections upon you. He's placed his anointing on you as big as he has anyone else. Listen, Satan's come to lie, discourage you, threaten you, intimidate you. He's come to do everything he possibly can to stop you. I'm telling you, there's a shield of faith that will quench every fire at darts of the wicked. Hallelujah. Yes, hallelujah. Where is your faith? Amen. When you start saying, Master, carest thou not that we perish? Then next thing say, where is your faith? Then next thing say, I'm going to start building myself up in my holy faith, praying in the Holy Ghost right now. Until I touch heaven, heaven touches me. I'm going to cry out to God till I begin to feel the surges of divine glory rushing through my being. Amen. Jesus transfigured before him. You talk about the surges of divine glory rushing through his being. Hallelujah. I'm in expectation of that. I'm in expectation to be translated. I'm in expectation to shine with the glory of his presence. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I'm in expectation to step into all the fullness of his ministry, do these works and great works. I don't have time to be unhappy about whatever is going on.
That's right.
I'm busy thinking about what's getting ready to happen. Huh? I'm there. I'm looking into the author and finisher of my faith. I have no time to be involved with the cares of this life. I have no time to be beset with the things that belong to this world. The weights of attachment to what I can do with my own life. I don't have my own life. It's time you don't have your own life either, because that's what you signed up for. You don't have your own life. Quit trying to take it back. Huh? Quit trying to take it back. Quit trying to take it back. Hallelujah. I know Satan hates me when I start saying things like that. I know he pulls out every accusation, every rebuttal he can. But now I speak Greek. So I can stop all of the rebuttal just by quoting a scripture in Greek. Hallelujah. Niggas, I scare the people who's going to give the rebuttal. I scare them with the Greek. Amen. Hallelujah. Takana sadinga blakada shalabakataya. Makatana manjanda lakataya namandai. You don't live. You're not your own. You don't, this is not your life. You don't have the right to decide. You don't have the right. You don't have the right to decide. You gave yourself over to the living God to rule you, master you, lead you, guide you, make his decisions for you, give the will of the Father to you. What a great blessing. Be impossible to you ever to know and understand the will of God till this wonderful work of redemption took place. I'm going to fully seize my opportunity. People look around, see the obstacles and see why all the reasons they can't. I see all the reasons I can. I'm like Caleb and I'm going to prove it. I'm like Joshua and I'm going to prove it. I see all the reasons I can. Why everybody's saying we can't? Because all I see is Jesus, and he's the I can. He's the I've done it. He's the I am the Alpha, and he is the I am the Omega. Amen. Hallelujah. Huh? He is I started it, and he is I finished it. He is I did it, and I'm going to do it through you. Hallelujah. Therefore, I know I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Of myself, I can do nothing, so I despise it. I don't look to myself to do anything. Cursed is the man who trusts in doing his things in himself.
Cursed is the man who can say, I can do it. Cursed is the man who say, I can do it. Uh-uh. I'm not saying I can do it of my own self. I'm saying I can do all things through Christ Jesus because I don't live my own life. I'm not going to step out and go reach another nation for my own credit, for my own reasons, for my own purposes. I'm going to go out and do what God commanded me to do. And that's what you're going to do. And I'm not going to give you any rest. I'm not going to give the Father any rest so that He won't give you any, so that you won't have any rest. It's time you become valiant.
Yes.
It's time you rise up and say, goodbye. I'm not living my life for this world anymore. I'm going to step out on the sea. I'm going to step out in faith now. I'm going to step all the way out in faith. I'm going to put it all on the line. I'm going to do or die, sink or swim. I'm going to kind of say, hallelujah. Pora sapratea. Tokalima nakataya. You know, I'm reminding Joshua, I'm reminding them right now, I'm reminding them constantly, don't forget what you're doing as they're there, in school, and they're trying to stuff your head with every kind of, you know, responsibility, every kind of piece of information, every kind of idea, and trying to jam a bunch of pride of life into your spirit. You there for one reason. You there because God has placed you there to open up opportunities in the kingdom, to advance His causes. That's it. You're doing it just for Him. You're doing it just for the things that belong to His praise and to His glory. So praise is first. Thanksgiving is first. The anointing is above all other things. Not wearing yourself out with studies because you want to rejoice in some good grade. Forget about it. Huh? What are you going to do? Walk around and show people your grades for the rest of your life? Give me a break. Ain't nobody going to be impressed. They're going to think that you need some kind of medication. But I tell you what people will be impressed about. When you speak life into them and they're not sorrowful and depressed anymore. I tell you what people will be impressed about. When you speak the word of deliverance for them and they're not tormented and they're vexed in their spirit anymore. When you take their little baby who's got some kind of disease, some kind of terrible problem, you take the baby up in your hands and you say in Jesus' name and the baby's made completely whole. You set the baby down and the baby for the first time goes running around playing like all other children. Hallelujah. 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 I figure to do great things in the kingdom of God, but I must learn how to be the servant of all first. And that's break me. Hallelujah. That's break me. That's melt me. That's mold me. To make me. So many people, there's people that have already left the meeting. It's so sad because it's a testimony to their life. They can't get the breakthrough. They're not willing to stay long enough to get the breakthrough. Not willing to stay long enough in His presence to get the breakthrough. They're not willing to go past the uncomfortable situations of their life to get the breakthrough. But stay with me. Mm-hmm. Stay with them. Yeah. Come on now. Come on. Mm-hmm. Come on. Come on. Stay with me. Yes. Stay with us. Put God first. Yes. Make this realm. Don't get discouraged. Don't get discouraged. Don't get discouraged. The Comforter is here to comfort you, to encourage you. Don't get discouraged. Father's promised He'll also do it. Just make sure that you understand you've got to want this more than anything else in this life. And that's what Jesus said when He said, first seek the kingdom. He said, you've got to want this more than anything else in this life, and then you can have it. That's what He said. You got to want this more than anything else in this life, and then you can have it. You got to want the things of the kingdom. You got to want the things that He has for you. You got to want His realm and His righteousness more than anything in this life, and then you can have it. It's yours. And then everything else will be added unto you. You don't believe God? You don't believe God? You think God's making that up? You don't think that's real? Then maybe you're not going to raise from the dead. If that's not real, then what He said about you raising from the dead ain't real either. Then what He said about escaping the torments of hell and being freed from your sin, cleansed from your sin, ain't real either. You can't pick and choose. It's time you prove the Lord.
time you prove what you believe. It's time you step out, start finding out whether or not he's God says, prove me. He ain't no problem with that. Prove me. See if I won't do what I said I'll do when you do what I've commanded you to do. This is what he said. Of course, he said in Malachi, he was talking about finances with that, but really it applies across the board. Prove me. See if I won't do what I said I'd do when you obey me and do what I've commanded you to do. Dear people, you have children in school right now. They're under more social pressures than any children have ever been under in a secular school system. How are they supposed to make it? Adults can't make it in this world. It's so vexed with temptation. It's so vexed with demonic influence. People are constantly being overwhelmed. I cried out to God the other night, Father, the temptations are so great. Who can stand? Only the people that are going to live like I'm talking about right now with total abandonment. How do we expect our children to stand under the social pressures, not even to talk about the demonic pressures that are there in the secular system and especially in the educational system? I mean, that if we're gonna participate with that craziness, at least we should be fasting and praying on our face, continually interceding that they'd be able to be protected. It seems like we lost and blind, can't see far off. God help us. We got to make a difference here, people. We got to get together here and make a difference. I'm not asking you to believe what I believe. I'm asking you to believe what God believes. I'm not asking you to believe what I believe. I'm asking you to believe what's written in the Word. I'm asking you to awake. I'm asking you to awake from your sleep. Awake, O thou that sleepest. Awake. Look at what's going on. That's all I'm asking here. You don't have to believe what I said. Just go and look at all the proofs and look at all the agenda and look at what the education system is demanding of our children. Look at all the stuff that's going on from the immorality of sexting to the anti-God position that our school system has taken with respect to every issue when it comes to the truth of the Bible and the Word of God and prayer. Oh, God, help us. Lord, help us. We've got to have a revival. We have to have an awakening. We have to have a moving of God. We have to have a turning back to God. It's got to start with me. It's got to start with you. It's got to start with us, the church. It's got to start here. It's got to be a complete giving over to what God said, meeting the full conditions and requirements of those things which He's demanded. It has to be. It has to be. We got to have to start esteeming His Word more than our necessary food. We're going to have to give no rest to our eyes until God comes and moves. We're going to have to rise at midnight and praise Him. We're going to have to begin to live, in other words, for Him, fully live for Him. Forget all this other stuff.
Yeah.
Satan's trying to stop us on every turn. Mm-hmm. He's fighting us right, left, and center. There's only one way to succeed. Be hidden in Him. Yes. To be hidden in Him. To be hidden in Him. To be hidden in Him. To be hid away in Him. Hid away in Him. Hid away. Father, we cry out for Your mercy tonight. For on every person in this place, we cry out for Your mercy, oh God. Your mercy, Lord.
Yes, Lord Jesus.
Father, we pray in the name of Jesus that from this day forward, not any person in this building would allow anything of this world or compromise to this world or giving over to the things of self-interest and the pursuit of one's own self-interest, Lord, but rather fully live for You so that we might apprehend and understand those things, oh God, for which You redeemed us and purchased us, which You poured out the Holy Ghost so that we may have these things. 2 Peter chapter 1, I'm going to close reading this quickly. Peter says, after having gone through the list of the things that we need to be occupied with, the things, by the way, that the modern day church is saying we don't need to even consider, huh? Because if we consider giving all diligence to making our election sure, then we're surely going to be doing some kind of works. Huh? They didn't know a concept of relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ and love. I'd like to see what kind of practical outworking that is in a relationship with their wife or their husband. That's nonsense.
They're so deceived. My goodness, but I'm not going to get into that. Peter says, then, for an entrance shall be ministered to you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord Jesus, our Savior, our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. He says, therefore, I will not be negligent to put you always in remembrance of these things, though you know them, and be established in the present truth. Listen to this. He says, I'm going to stay at this thing. I am going to constantly tell you about these things. I'm going to constantly challenge you in them, even though you know them and are established in them. I'm going to tell you again, give all diligence to making your calling and election sure. I'm going to tell you to walk in the divine nature. I'm going to tell you to give all diligence to adding to your virtue, faith. I'm going to tell you to get after godliness. I'm going to get after you with respect to how you're supposed to walk in all purity and holiness. And in verse 13, yes, I think it is important, necessary, as long as I am in this tabernacle, to even as the Lord Jesus Christ has shown me. Forgive me. Yes. Yea, I think it is necessary, as long as I am in this tabernacle, to stir you up. Hallelujah. By putting you in remembrance of these things. In other words, it should be like stirring hot coals in the fireplace. It stokes the flame. That's what it should do. All these things should do when I start talking about holiness and purity and godliness and virtue and going after this glory and going after these things in the spirit and going after this realm of this entrance that God would minister to us. It should just be like stirring hot coals in the fireplace in your life. It shouldn't cause discouragement. It should cause you to rise up with boldness and confidence and certainty and that much more passion about pursuing what God's called you to do. Hallelujah. The lying powers of darkness that come to accuse, I bind them in the name of Jesus Christ. The lying powers of darkness that come to create condemnation and a sense of failure, you lying power of hell, you obey me in Jesus' name. You leave the people of God alone. That's Satan's strategy against the army of God to keep his people from ever even being able to begin to move. But there's an access. It's the pride of life. It's looking to one's own self-ability, own self. It was too much trusting in self that Satan is able to access you. And then it becomes competitive. God has nothing to do with competition. It becomes about what you can do versus what somebody else is doing. And then it becomes like, oh, is he saying he's better than me? Or is he saying that she's better than her or whatever? All that nonsense comes from a demonic realm. That's the only way that the enemy could access you and even begin to discourage you. And begin to take the word of God in life that's supposed to stir you up and inflame your heart and passions for the things of God and try to turn it against you and use it to stop you and make you feel like a failure and overwhelmed with defeat. You bind that lie. You recognize that comes nothing but from hell itself. Amen. It's Satan's attack in this hour. This is a dark day. But though gross darkness be over the people, God's light shall rise upon us. Huh? His glory shall be seen upon us. His people are going to shine brighter and brighter. Even like the noonday sun, as the day approaches, I'm telling you, there's going to be a greater manifestation of divine power and glory manifested in this earth. And I'll be right in the big middle of it. And I plan on seeing you there too.
Amen.
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 Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Moreover, I will endeavor that ye may be able, after my decease, to have these things always in your remembrance. I mean, that's the way to grab a hold of vision. I'm going to begin to give myself and labor in the kingdom, Peter is saying, to where that you so fully get it now, and after I'm dead, it's still going to be talking. I'm going to participate in something that's going to last till Jesus comes.
Amen.
We just follow. That doesn't happen by accident. That doesn't happen because you gave the Lord 10% of your time. That doesn't happen because you showed up to the meeting every time. That happened because you sold out to Jesus. That happens because you recognize you've been bought with a price and you're not your own and you're not going to live for yourself. You're living for the kingdom of God.
Yes.
You praying, crying out to God every day, Lord, send me, use me. Yes. I'll go for you. I don't want the things of this world. I don't want the cares of this life. I don't want the riches that, I don't want the comforts. I don't want the ease that this world can give. I want the comfort and the rest that only you can supply.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Yes. Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Just forget about it. Forget about all this world. Forget about it. Right? Forget about all the pressures and other things that people say you got to go and do. Forget about it. Only remember what Jesus said.
Yes.
Only remember what God has declared.
Yes.
Hallelujah. King Branjola para separate. Somebody said, well, if I don't save up, I won't be able to go on a vacation. Hey, listen, forget about it. God has sent you on a vacation that you'll never forget. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. For we have not followed cunningly devised fables when we made known unto you the power and the coming of the Lord Jesus Christ. We were eyewitnesses of his majesty. For he received from God the Father honor and glory. When there came such a voice to him from the excellent glory, this is my beloved Son in whom I am well pleased. And this voice which came from heaven we heard when we were with him in the holy mount. We have also a more sure word of prophecy, whereunto you do well if you take heed as unto a light that shines in a dark place until the day dawn and the day star arise in your hearts. Knowing this first. Knowing this first. A first thing that you need to understand and get established above all other things. No prophecy of Scripture is of any private interpretation. For the prophecy came not in old time by the will of men, but holy men of God spake as they were moved by the Holy Ghost. This word of God that we call the Bible is absolutely the express will and demands of the living God. It is his covenant. In the Hebrew language, the word is barit. When it was translated over into the Greek language, the only Greek word that could be found to fill the bill, to be even measured to covenant, is a word that means last will and testament. The Lord has clearly defined for you and me what we're supposed to do, not what we're supposed to memorize so that we may be good little Christians. What we are supposed to do, what we are supposed to believe and do. Now it's time to stop messing around. The Lord gave us a new heart. He took away the stony heart that would constantly refuse to do what he said. To constantly be in a state of refusing to do what God says is to be just like Israel, who God said there is no heart in them to obey me. He gave us a new heart. The new covenant is defined as this: to have a new heart that has his statutes and his judgments written in them so that we would do them. His covenant, his will, his testament. It's time now. It's time now. It's time now for you to begin to enter into a relationship with the Lord Jesus Christ where sadness and sorrow has no place. It's time now for you to begin to enter into a relationship where doubt and uncertainty has no place. It's time now for you to begin to enter into a relationship where boldness and assurance fills your heart and faith's the way that you live. Jesus, just rest on. Don't anybody disturb Jesus. I'll take care of this. Wind, I told you now, I'm not going to say it very loud because I don't want to wake him up. I told you now to stop blowing And ways I tell you right now, you don't you raise your ugly head again. And now it's done. Huh? And if you don't have enough boldness in that, you can just stand there with your hands lifted towards the heaven and say, Lord, I'm coming home. Coming home. Huh? Whatever. Whatever works. Everybody, whatever you're going to do, you're not going to say, Lord, don't you even care? Why am I going through this again? What's wrong with me? What's wrong with you? Or whatever. Everybody stand with me. Thank you, Lord Jesus. I want you to understand, dear people, every person in the body of Christ, it is God's will that you bring something. And most of the time, this has been reduced down to nothing more than an offering in terms of money. But that's really one of the minor things. It's probably the least thing in many ways. The glory of His house, the splendor and the beauty of His house, the ornaments of His house are the expressions of the giftings of the Holy Ghost, the abilities which God gives by His Spirit that are supposed to operate through each one, each member in the body of Christ, each person. That's where this manifestation of His power, that's where the glory of His church, the authority of His church begins to go to a whole nother level. But I understand, we all understand that those things aren't going to be reality without a relationship that causes you to no longer have room for sorrow, disappointment, discouragement, doubt, fear, torment. Tonight, Jesus is calling you. He's calling out to His people. He said to you, His people, all you that labor and heavy laden, come unto me, I'll give you rest. And there's joy in His rest. There's peace in His rest. There's confidence in His rest. There's assurance in His rest. There's boldness in His rest. There's certainty. Father, we cannot possibly run the risk of continuing in any way, shape, or form as we have been. Father, we thank You tonight for greater increase. We thank You for strengthening every single person by the Spirit. We thank You for greater boldness. We thank You for greater confidence. Father, I thank You right now that every person in this place with great and total and absolute resolve surrenders themselves over or yields themselves completely to do Your will alone, O God. Your will alone, Father. Your will alone, Father. Father, look at our lives. See this assembly tonight. Father, I pray in Jesus' name, in the mighty name of Jesus. Ibrahim Mondembra Denganda, the Tese Potevi Fratatai, the Befitoya Pila, Ivretane, the Tesotonga. Father, for the miracle that nothing can be the same, for the miracle, O God, of Your presence, and the miracle of Your glory, and the miracle of Your divine power, the miracle, O God, that works in our lives to where that we ourselves have not any ability anymore to continue on as things have been. But Father, under Your mandate, under the force of Your divine will, totally compelled, filled by Your grace with the knowledge of Your will. Meleng meng leng jarum. Meleng jeng brudam bande. Meleng beng je premangando saponga de freteya shoda baranambra dea. Boros tapen and imikiti di damambla satana. Membrebekiri de bekana sai. In the name of Jesus. Boremanganda bongele mai. Father, we thank you for encouragement. Father, we thank you for strength. We thank you for confidence. We thank you for boldness. Oh God, in the mighty name of Jesus. Lakarondo barese di dara. We thank you for comfort. We thank you, O God, for the assurance that we have all the help that we need. Father, I thank you for a fresh vision. I thank you for refreshing, O God. Father God, in the mighty name of Jesus, by the power of the Holy Ghost. Ibrebe mambre de gida la mambroso to remere. Ibrebe mangalan jebrebe mandolo boso to ya. Ibrebe kana manjese to yo roboso si. Mena ire mande ipretoye. Boraba, just continue to pray with me. Mana manda mana sharabate. Gerebe la boso po ki alana mandamre ba elebebra. Begin to pray with me till you break into that realm of divine power and glory, till you strengthened by the Spirit. Father, we thank you for the encouragement of the Holy Ghost, for the refreshing of the Holy Ghost, for the strengthening power of the Holy Ghost. Mama mananda beresita yede mengle. Mongro mama mande beresita la na mangola. Ikarabashakoto yibrebete alabosoto ne mengle. Father, I thank you that the floodlight of heaven shines upon every heart and life tonight. Father, that everything that is unlike you has to be sent away in Jesus' name. Hallelujah. It is Suramon Rebeng Langdai. Ura Mama Mamba, Dem Langdom, Blanjaco, Ye Sheritona, Sheremena, Jele Mengberu Soto. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Kirima Mangana, Monje Limande, Brebayo Shena. Now, in Jesus' name, be strengthened by the Spirit and find a realm in which you continue in. Doromong Jakaya. Be strengthened by the Spirit. Find a realm in which you can continue in from this day forward. Not letting up. No more letting up. No more just letting things be as they are. But pressing in and taking hold of God. Taking hold of the things that He has provided. The door that He's opened. The entrance that He's made. Ooh, Shikaraba. Father, we cry out. We cry out, oh God. We cry out to you for this nation. We cry out for the state of affairs of the church. We cry out, oh God, for the government of this land. We cry out for the nations of this earth, oh God. Lord, we ask you to prepare us, strengthen us, send us, oh God, our Father, to the highways, the byways, the streets, the houses, the townships, the villages, the cities, the counties, the states, oh God. Yeah, Usana Mangel, Mambra Daini Shekai, Katuishi. Father, we renounce every hidden thing. We renounce everything in this world. We renounce our own life also to live only for you, O God. Father, to do your will. Father, to live fully for you, Lord Jesus. Right now, I bring the nation of the United States of America before you. I bring the churches of this nation before you now, Father. In your mercy,
mercy, oh God. Pour out your divine power. Pour out your glory, oh God. Oh God, in your mercy, pour out your strength. Pour out the revelation of your divine grace. Pour out the revelation of your divine will, oh God. In Jesus' name. Father, we pray, glorify the name of Jesus. Glorify the name of your only begotten Son. Father, we pray in Jesus' name. God, Rustopaya, Tushaya, Labakusha, Brebe, Yamangataya, Ishalamombom, Brebe, Etek Osha. Father, we pray that rivers of your glory, that rivers of your presence will flow forth from your people everywhere. Oh God, especially here, right here in this place. Father, we thank you for divine power and authority over sickness and disease. We thank you for divine power over sin and iniquity. Father, we thank you for divine power over every unholy, ungodly thing, for every divine power over every force of darkness, every evil spirit, every demon power. Father, we thank you for your protection. We thank you for your fire. We thank you for your glory. We thank you for your provision. Father, we thank you for increasing faith within our lives. So God, as we walk out this relationship with you, Father, we thank you for the grace of hunger and thirsting after righteousness. We thank you for the grace of the Spirit of the Son crying out within us, Abba, Father. Just continue to pray till you touch heaven. Pray in the Holy Ghost until you touch heaven. There ain't no reason to come to the meeting and not touch heaven. There's no reason to come to the meeting and just hear the words of God and not then have them applied in your life and have them become a living, viable force that brings the change that God demands. Father, we cry out to you. We cry out, Father, for your moving, for the revivals of the past to be greater now, oh God, in this present day. Father, for the revival of your presence, the revival of the moving of your mighty power, the revival of the moving of your Holy Spirit, of the conviction, oh God, of the glory, oh God, of your grace, oh God, of your manifest presence. Sutrinanana. Sutri babari baba. Sombagi yadabraba mashikarime. In the name of Jesus, we command that everything comes into line. We command everything that comes under the authority of the name of Jesus Christ and under the authority of his word. Now, I want to pray specifically for anybody, anyone that you've just been overwhelmed, that you don't know, not been able to understand how to let the Holy Ghost lead you. We pray, oh God, when my heart is overwhelmed, lead me to the rock that is higher than I, and referring to the rock from which the water poured out in the wilderness and God provided drink from heaven, which, of course, Paul told us was Christ Jesus. And the water that they drank of was that water of life, the water of the Spirit. if you've been trapped, you don't know how to get out. You don't know how to move forward. You don't know how to stay in this wonderful place of joy divine. We just want to be helpers of your faith tonight. We'll lay hands on you, pray for you, believe God will touch you. We want you to find a realm. We don't want you to leave here tonight not knowing how to touch heaven, because heaven's wanting so desperately to fill you up.
No reason to go home sad, discouraged, unhappy, still uncertain. All of that is a realm of doubt. It's also a realm of unbelief. There is without faith, it's impossible to please God, and God has come to bring you all the faith that you possibly need. We want to lay hands on you and pray for you. If you're sick in your body, I know there are a number of people that didn't come tonight because they're sick in their body. I want to encourage you. If you're watching on the web right now and you didn't come because you're sick, come. Come. Gain mastery over that sickness that would try to stop you. And I'm telling you right now, this is what you do. You don't get stopped by the things that would try to beset you or stop you or hold you back. You keep moving forward. You keep moving forward. You don't stop. You don't lay down to it. You don't obey it. You don't accommodate it in any way. I don't care what form, fashion it comes in. Whether it's financial, physical, spiritual, it does not matter. Don't accommodate the nonsense. Don't accommodate sadness. Don't accommodate doubt. Don't accommodate questions. Hallelujah. Just be a little child and be led. Right now, in the name of Jesus, I command every sickness and disease go off your body right now. Those of you that are home right now, you're sick, be healed in Jesus' name. I command you, in Jesus' name, I command you, be healed in Jesus' name. You foul spirit of sickness and disease, obey me in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you that you give to us a spirit of wisdom and revelation and knowledge of you, that our eyes can be opened so that we can see. Hallelujah. Father, tonight we thank you that you open up our eyes. You anoint our eyes with eye salve so that we can see. Father, I thank you that tonight your people's hearts in the abiding place will be comforted, being knit together in love. Unto all riches of the full assurance of understanding. Father, I thank you for the great wealth that there is in the full assurance of understanding. And the ability to acknowledge the mystery. The wonderful, glorious mystery of God. And of the Father, and of Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. He's in you. It's what Papa says. He says he's in you. Can you feel him in you? He's in you. Can you feel him in you? Holy Ghost is in you. Can you feel him in you? If you cannot feel him in you, I want to pray for you right now. Can you feel him in you? If you cannot feel him in you, come asate ite paio. Oh, ramamanda sita inangula paiete. Right now, in Jesus' name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Father. Well, come worship the Lord with your offering, with your giving. Find a bunch of people around you. Hug them. Tell them that you love them. Bless them in Jesus' name. Find as many people as you haven't hugged recently and hug them to start with. Don't start with your family. You can hug them at home. Find a bunch of people. Hug them. Tell them that you love them. Bless them in Jesus' name. Worship the Lord. Worship the Lord with your giving. I know it's gotten late, got late quick, just the way things happen. Once again, if you want prayer, I want to pray with you, and I want to pray for you. If you want prayer for any reason, come. Si baramong de sikiti di dambolo poras te prete. La rana da basikiri di bonono mase preteya. Lura mama mandandale si tele de kipre bebera satandale de pepe picanu sepana na preteya. Sikanda do mundo de defeti.
Father, in Jesus' name. In Jesus' name. Father, in Jesus' name. Father, I thank you for great Holy Ghost conviction. I thank you for your fear of God. I thank you for the awesomeness of your presence. Father, I ask you now in your mercy and your love, touch this people. Touch every single person in this place, especially these that are standing here right now, God. Whatever the need may be, I just want you to lift your hands towards heaven. I want you to know and believe what Father's purpose to do with your life. Now in the name of Jesus, every power of darkness, every force of hell that has tried its best to stop you, it's over. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, I break the strongholds of the enemy from off of you. Every lying power of darkness has to leave you alone. God strengthens you to be able to stand against whatever it is that's been coming out against you. God has made you well able to overcome it. He's made you well able to speak to the word of faith to it. Now in Jesus' name, receive. In Jesus' name, receive. That's it. Just receive. That's it. The blessing of God. Just receive. Papa loves you now. He loves you so much. Thank you, Jesus, for the anointing of the Holy Ghost.